So, you've learned how to use RayMMD, but now you want your videos to look even more realistic? Don't worry, I've got you covered. In this video, I'll teach you how to create realistic scenes in MMD by making and using your own custom RayMMD materials. Now let's get started. First, you'll need to download the stages and model that we will use in this tutorial so you can follow along. Download links are in the description. You'll also need a basic understanding of how to use RayMMD. If you don't know how to set up RayMMD, the good news is, I have an easy-to-follow basic RayMMD tutorial on my channel. Link is in the description below. Now, let's learn how texture maps work in MMD. To make materials look realistic in MMD, we first need to understand the different PBR texture maps used in 3D rendering. Let's start with the base color map. It is also known as the albedo or diffuse map. This map gives your model color, but without any shadows or highlights. Think of it as the plain paint job before anything fancy happens. The roughness map controls how smooth or rough a surface looks. Black areas represent smooth and shiny surfaces, while white areas represent rough surfaces. Next is the metallic map. As the name suggests, this map determines whether your object looks like metal. White areas represent metal, while black areas represent non-metallic materials. The ambient occlusion map adds soft shadows in areas where light struggles to reach, like corners and seams. It makes your 3D models look more realistic by enhancing subtle depth and detail. A normal map adds fake bumps and details without changing the shape of the surface, making it great for performance. A displacement map, on the other hand, actually changes the surface of the object, adding real bumps and dents, which makes it more realistic than a normal map. Stick to normal maps if your PC is getting slow when using displacement maps. When creating custom materials in RayMMD, these texture maps have different names. The base color map is called albedo, the normal map remains normal, the roughness map is smoothness, the metallic map is metalness, the ambient occlusion map is occlusion, and the displacement map is height. Now, enough with the boring part. Let's start applying what we've learned in MMD to make some realistic materials. First, go to ambientcg.com. This site provides free, high-quality texture maps for 3D projects. Now, click on Materials at the top of the page. You'll see a variety of textures for different materials like wood, metal, and stone. For this tutorial, we'll use a wood material for the floor. In the search bar, type wood floor 043. Click on Shading Preview to check how the texture will look when applied in MMD. It's a great way to visualize the material before downloading. When you're ready, choose a resolution to download. The higher the resolution, the more detailed the texture will be. For this tutorial, we'll download the 2K resolution in PNG format. Now, go to RayMMD's material folder and create a new folder. Name it Wood Floor. Inside the Wood Floor folder, extract the zip file we downloaded. You'll see different texture maps. Next, go back to RayMMD's materials folder, copy material 2.0.fx and material common 2.0.fx sub, and paste them inside the folder you just made. Now, open material 2.0fx. This is where we'll link the texture maps we downloaded. Usually, you would update the code to match the texture map names. For example, copy woodfloor 0432k PNG color and replace albedo.png in the code. Copy woodfloor 0432k PNG metalness and replace metalness.png. Repeat this for each texture map like roughness, occlusion, and so on. But to simplify this process so we don't have to change the code, we'll rename the files instead. Rename woodfloor 043 color to albedo. Rename woodfloor 043 metalness to metalness. Rename woodfloor 043 roughness to smoothness. Rename Wood Floor 043 Ambient Occlusion to Occlusion. Rename Wood Floor 043 Displacement to Height. There are two normal maps. Since MMD uses OpenGL, rename Normal GL to Normal and ignore the other normal map. Finally, delete any unnecessary files in the folder to save space. Now that we've finished creating the custom material, let's use it in MMD. First, open MMD with Ray MMD already set up. Load your stage by going to Model Manipulation, clicking Load, navigating to your stage folder, and selecting the PMX file. Next, apply Ray MMD to the stage. Go to MME, click Effect Mapping, and in the Main tab, apply main.fx to the stage. Then, adjust the lighting so the shadows don't block the scene. Go to Light Manipulation and set X to 0.7, Y to negative 0.3, and Z to negative 1. Now, click the Material Map tab in MME. Right-click the stage and select Subset Extract. Uncheck and recheck Subset 0 to confirm it's the floor material. Double-click Subset 0, navigate to Ray MMD's Materials folder, go to the Wood Floor folder, and select Material 2.0.fx. As you can see, it still doesn't apply the texture maps. That's because we haven't turned it on yet. To turn it on, open the Material 2.0.fx file inside the Wood Floor folder. Set Albedo Map From to 1 to turn on the albedo or base color. Set Normal Map From to 1 to activate the normal map. Set Smoothness Map to 1 to enable the roughness map. Set Metalness Map From to 1 to activate the metallic map. Set Occlusion Map From to 1 to enable ambient occlusion. Finally, set Parallax Map From to 1 to turn on the height or displacement map. Save your changes by going to File and selecting Save. Now, you'll see the textures applied to the floor. If you want to adjust the material's depth, modify the height map by changing the value of Parallax Map Scale. For example, let's set it to 0.2. If the texture pattern looks too big or too small, adjust it by changing the value of Parallax Map Loop Num. Let's set it to 1.5 for this example. You can also simply turn off the displacement map if you think the normal map looks good enough on its own. You've now learned how to use custom materials with Ray MMD. But wait, what if you want to generate texture maps from the stage's default texture instead? Let's find out next. Sometimes, you just want to enhance the details of an existing stage without replacing its textures entirely. Take this stage for example. The floor looks fine, but its texture feels flat and lacks depth. In this section, we'll create custom texture maps to make it more realistic and bring it to life. First, just like in the previous chapter, make a folder where you'll save the texture maps we're about to create, and copy Material 2.0.fx and Material Common 2.0.fxsub into it. Next, in your browser search bar, type Normal Map Online. You can use any normal map generator you want, but for this tutorial, we'll pick the first result. I'll leave the website link in the video description in case your results are different. Now, let's create our first normal map. Upload the floor's texture by clicking the image on the left side of the site. Go to your stage folder, then to its texture folder, and select the ground or floor texture. In the 3D preview, set the model type to plane and zoom in so we can see what we're doing clearly. As you can see, the normal map looks a bit rough, so let's adjust it. Use the strength and level sliders until it looks smooth and fits your preference. Once you're satisfied, download all the texture maps to the folder we created and name each texture map according to what it's called in Material 2.0.fx, so we don't have to rename them later. Lastly, OpenMaterial2.0.fx and turn on the maps we're using. Normal map, specular map, occlusion map, and displacement map, just like we did before. Now, in MMD, apply the material we just made to the stage's floor. You'll see it doesn't look flat anymore. You can also adjust the pattern size and depth by editing material 2.0.fx, just like we did last chapter. For the last part, let's learn how to add textures to the model's clothes and how to change its color. For clothes, you only need a normal map. You can download a cloth normal map, or if you'd like to use the same one I use in this video, I'll leave the download link in the video description below. To turn on the normal map, open material2.0.fx and set the value of normal map from to 1. Now, in MMD, apply the cloth material that you made. You can see that the normal map is applied, but its pattern is too big. In material2.0.fx, you can change the pattern size and depth of the normal map by adjusting the value of normal map scale and normal map loop num. For this example, let's set the value of normal map scale to 0.5 and normal map loop num to 10. Remember to save every time you make changes to the code. When you zoom in, you can see the normal map is applied to the model's cloth, but we can't see it properly because the cloth's color is black. To change the cloth's color, set the value of albedo map from to 0. Then change the value of the albedo variable to a float 3 format. These three numbers represent red, green, and blue, with values ranging from 0 to 1. For example, setting the first number to 1 turns the cloth bright red. Lowering the number reduces its brightness. Let's change the value to 0.4. You can combine red, green, and blue to create different colors. For example, setting red to 0.3 and blue to 0.3 changes the cloth's color to violet. If you want the cloth to be shiny, make sure smoothness map from is 0 since we're not using a roughness map, then adjust the value of smoothness. For this example, let's set it to 0.5. Lastly, if you want the cloth to be metallic, make sure metalness map from is 0 since we're not using a metallic map. Then adjust the value of metalness. Let's set it to 0.3. Did you enjoy the tutorial? As a final tip, instead of material2.0.fx, you can also use materialeditor.fx, which comes with a controller, giving you more control inside MMD. Make sure to edit the last part of the code and remove the dots and slashes before material.common2.0.fx-sub. If you made it this far, let me know in the comments section by adding this emoji at the end of your comment. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye.